All right, hello folks. Welcome to, I think we're on part 5 now of this build. And in this video, I don't know exactly what we're going to be doing, but I know we're definitely going to be fixing the tank and doing some other stuff. So right now, I'm going to take this engine off of here and start taking this thing down apart a little bit. This isn't exactly on point, but I got this 24-piece wrench set, which is in empirical and metric, and I got it for only $34 on eBay. So, a lot cheaper. Like, if you just go to Lowe's or Home Depot and try to get a wrench set, they're miles more expensive, like $50 for half of this wrench set. So, I'm glad I was able to find that deal. Now, I don't think they're the highest of quality, but I think they're going to work good for this application. Forget that thing's so heavy. Now, one thing I realized is that this device has its own check valve in it, but this here is also a check valve, and so I think that possibly is why it's making that popping sound when it starts unloading the pressure, is because it can't consistently unload it because this check valve prevents any backflow to this valve. So maybe I need to eliminate this check valve because this already has one. Although in order to do that, I'd have to pull this out, and I already tried, and as you can see from the marks, it's hard. You can't really get a socket down on there because there's this nonsense, whatever this is. That was actually it kind of releases the pressure in here. I don't know why it needs to be released, but I just have it sitting here. I probably should get a little cap for that or something, but it prevents me from putting a socket all the way onto that. But I'm going to see if I can get that thing out and take a look at it. These may not like hammering, but now I think they use red Loctite because you can see it's red. So it's probably going to be a super big pain to remove. I doubt this will help any, but might as well give it a try. Alright, well, to get to some of this stuff better, I'm deciding to take off the compressor, and I took off the gauges and everything. That thing's pretty gross. Alright. Well, we got big wrenches now, so I want this thing off, so it's gonna come off. It's probably gonna get damaged from this a little bit, but I don't know which tool is the best here. It budged. Oh boy. It budged. Still really hard, but it's... Wow. There's our check valve right there. That put up a fight. And you can see it's got battles. And you can see it's got battle scars from that, but... You know, it's still a usable part, and I'm probably going to replace this, or I'll maybe take apart the check valve and see if it runs better without it. Okay. Nice to have the right tool for the job. Spring should keep an eye on what order this stuff goes in, of course. So we got this like plunger thing, this bottom thing, and the spring, and it goes like that. Now we just got a hole that goes straight through. These kids use all my brake cleaner. Yeah, that's just a straight hole into there, so that has to be plugged somehow. Alright, well, now that I got everything off the tank and that plug out, and that check valve out, I think I'm gonna take the opportunity to clean out the tank, because listen to this, this is crazy. Here's some stuff in the bottom of there, which probably is not a good sign. So, of course, I'm also gonna be hopefully fixing this nonsense. But first, I'm gonna get this little plug off the bottom. So there's definitely rust in this tank, because if you look down that hole, you can see there's only a tiny little like slit in it. Really hard. Kind of compacted in there.
It was at this moment I realized.
Try to kind of slosh that around in there. There's definitely junk coming out of there. All right, well, I'm gonna turn this thing upside down and have it drain out of that bigger hole. Thank you. Alright, well, I got it cleaned out as best as I could, although there's definitely still some stuff rattling around in there, but a lot of it came out, I'm sure, because, well, a ton of stuff came out. That board that I was doing it on is completely covered in whatever rust flakes and stuff. So, you can see here someone did braze this at one point. And there are definitely some pinholes in this, obviously, which is why it was leaking out. There's definitely some right here. And I think there's one kind of somewhere in the middle of this. But either way, what we're going to be doing is taking this down so it's at least a little smoother. Although I don't want to take all this off in case there was a giant hole here. Because my idea for patching this up, we have some fiberglass resin body filler. And this was recommended to me by a friend. And hopefully this is going to work good. Because the reason I'm not welding it is if this was thin enough to get a hole in it, whether it be got scraped on the ground a lot or rusted through right there, you're not going to be able to weld it. It's just going to kind of blow holes in the metal. And as for the brazing, that probably would work, although I don't have access to that right now. And so this stuff I've heard is quite strong and hopefully will work for this application. Especially if you can kind of pack it into the hole so it goes in there somewhat. So yeah, I'm going to be taking this down. An angle grinder is what I need, but I'll try some different tools. Look at that shine. Quite nice. One hour filing. I don't know. That's the slight issue right there. There's where your problem is. I'm starting to uncover a larger hole, which I really don't want to do. So I think I'm going to stop now. I'm going to give you guys a real close look here. If this camera will focus. I can't even tell if it is because the screen's cracked. There we go. Nice big hole right there. And there's a crack that extends over here a little bit, and you can see it's still going right there. Right there, kind of comes across like that. And there's also some imperfections in the brazing that it might be able to leak through as well. So I'm hoping that this can plug that. It's a little cold right now. It's like high 40s, low 50s, and I'm not sure what the cure temperature for the epoxy is, or resin, I mean, whatever it is. Allow material to cure approximately 2 hours at 75 degrees Fahrenheit. Well, it ain't going to be 75 degrees Fahrenheit here until next year, so that's a slight issue. Curing will take longer at cold temperatures.
Oh boy.
I'm really used to seeing this stuff.
It's not so bad.
Wait, so this probably would just need a few drops. I would suspect.
Is that like water? Citric acid?
It's like a, it's a hardener. So it'll make this resin get hard.
Like
not immediately.
Glue?
Pretty much.
Oh, ding, even welding?
Ding, 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 ding,
ding, ding. Ding.
That's probably way too much. Oh, that's definitely way too much. Right?
Am I supposed to do a sort of mixture?
Yeah. I just dropped in a... I used the... the eyes for the measurement.
Oh, that makes it smell worse.
I guess I'll let this get slightly more hard, because otherwise it'll just fall down into the hole, and I don't want it to just flow into it a ton, but to kind of stick in it. Alright, so the next day, and it's had about 24 hours. Yeah, it's had basically about 24 hours to dry at this point. And so even though it's colder than they recommended, it should be dry enough at this point. It's definitely not at all tacky to the touch. I glued two rocks together with this stuff just to kind of see how strong it was and how quickly it would dry. And this stuff's hard. Also, does not smell good, even when it's dry. Slightly less bad than when it was wet, but still. These rocks are bonded together real good. Alright, time to put this thing back together. And since you saw me take it all apart, this is going to be a real fast time lapse. Alright, well, that took a few minutes, but we got her back together. I did use thread tape on some of the spots. I might need to do something here, because since our check valve is in this now and not in this fitting, this stuff will be under pressure all the time, even when this is no longer pumping. So I might need to put thread tape on those two. Possibly. Alright, so I got it out here and ready to test fire, and we'll see if this new check valve setup without the tank check valve works better. And we'll also see if our repair down there, if it holds. Hopefully it does. PSI. You can see there's a white liquid coming out. I think that's water. And a tiny, tiny little leak. So that's not good. I mean, there's definitely way smaller of a leak than we had before. So it's an improvement, but there is still a leak there. And we do have a leak right around this guy. Small leak there. So I need thread tape on that. Small leak there. Small leak here. Altogether better. You can see it's definitely not dropping at any high rate or anything. But I guess I'll turn the engine back on and pressurize it up and see how this valve works. Because I think this stuff's fully dried. It's just, I guess I missed a spot or something. I'll have to look at that. Clutch did not want to engage there, but this system's working good. So yeah, it was definitely good we eliminated that check valve, because you could hear this thing would go pss, and it wasn't even loud. In this engine, you could hear the load was reduced. The RPM went up a little, and it stopped, it sputtered a little less, because, and it stopped smoking. It wasn't smoking much, but just a little bit of black, was coming out. And then you could hear it, and it would, as it would unload the pressure, it would take the load off the engine. Because the engine was just dumping its pressure out the valve. But I'll probably put another coat of that stuff underneath. I'm not going to worry about taking everything off. I'll just wait till it stops dripping water, because there was still water in there from when I cleaned out the tank. I don't think it all came out. So the clutch was slipping. It's kind of a cheapo clutch, no doubt. But yeah, it definitely works a lot better when it's just this thing running on its own without a check valve that it's fighting with. Welcome back. It's been a while since you saw the last clip. And long story short, I've been trying, as you've seen, to repair this crack, and it just has not worked out. And I tried time after time to just use this Bondo resin, and it has not worked. It's been failing every time. So I'll give you the abridged version of that. Alrighty then. Bad news. It still leaks, and it's worse than it was before. How is that even possible? Alright, it's been about 24 hours, so it's the next day, and it's a lot colder today. It's in the high 30s, I believe, so hopefully it dried. If not, I mean, it's hard. So, I don't know if it's at full strength, but it's definitely very hard. Come on, baby. still leaks, and it's a bad leak. Or it's... Man, this is so disappointing. How? The whole thing's plugged. It's right where the plug is. There's full in here. I squirted a ton in there. I don't understand it.
To make a long story short, I tried one more time and it still didn't work.
Okay, so as you can see, that resin on its own is just not strong enough to hold up to the kind of pressures that we're going to be putting through it. And yeah, there's a pretty big hole there, although that is packed with resin. But yeah, so I got a fiberglass cloth, and this should actually be able to put on there with the resin, and this will provide the strength, and this will provide the sealing power. So let's get to work. Sorry we're in such a bad lighting environment. It's because this is the pump house, and it's the only place we have a heater that is not in the house. And obviously I can't bring this greasy thing in the house. So in the pump house it is. Alright. So I will be wearing gloves for this because, yeah, I like my fingers not full of fiberglass. So obviously I'm not going to need all of this. This is way too much. But that means I can just have more for other projects. Alright, so this is about the size we need to cover everything thoroughly. And I think I'm going to put like two layers just to be really safe. Sticky. I'll leave that overnight. Alright, well, it's the next day and it's had a long time to cure in the pump house over there. So hopefully it'll hold this time. I don't see how it couldn't. I mean, we got three layers of fiberglass on here. Three sheets of it with, of course, the resin. So yeah, all that's left to do is test it. Y'all have been wanting cold starts? Well, here you go. Put you right in the fire line of that exhaust. The arm. good. A lot of smoke coming out the intake there. Couldn't tell you what was going on with that. You know what, folks? You know what? This is excellent. No leak. No leak. Yes. Absolutely nothing. No leaking. Actually, I do hear. I think that's the regulator. That's just the regulator. I didn't have it screwed in all the way. I'm incredibly happy. We finally did it. We fixed the leak. Yes! It has been such a hard uphill battle to do this, but we finally done it. The last thing will be to paint the tank, because, I mean, the paint is just not in good shape, and especially down, obviously, I need to paint over where the fiberglass is. But yeah, it holds pressure. I expected it to, because I knew that there's no way that this could fail, and it didn't. So let's hope it stands the test of time. So, it is kind of cold here in Oregon, I mean, this time of year especially, so painting is going to be difficult. So I took everything back off it, and that's because I'm now going to pressure wash it and clean it up to get ready to be painted. Alright, so today it's a little bit warmer. It's about 50 degrees, and I have bought some paint. Now, there's a slight issue. So I bought the paint that the local hardware store had, which was the closest color to the engine as possible. So I say, okay, well, I did a little test, and yeah. So here's the color paint that I'm going to be painting the tank with, and here's the color that the engine is, and you can see it's definitely like too dark, a little too fluorescent, and I actually hit it with a little steel wool, and that made it quite a bit better. It took down the kind of glossiness a little bit. So I don't know. I think it's not going to match perfectly. That's just 100% guarantee. But I really want to get a coat on this, because that way it'll help prevent further rusting, and stuff like that. And also it'll make it look a little better. So I'm just going to do the upper half right now. I have everything taped off, and then I'll flip it around once it's dry and do the lower half. Okay, so it says between 50 degrees Fahrenheit and 90 degrees Fahrenheit. So we're at the very bottom end of that. I know I'm going to be painting over the stickers, but believe me, the stickers are in bad condition. Alright, I think we're pretty thoroughly mixed. It's obviously going to look a lot more glossy and shiny and bright when it's wet, but we'll wait till it dries. flip it over and do the bottom. All right, it's had enough time to dry a little bit. And, well, we got it flipped over, and I did a little bit of sanding on the edges of this fiberglass, so it'd at least feel a little bit better. I'm not too concerned about it. This part's going to be under the tanks. I didn't want to sand the top too much because I don't want to take any chances with weakening it, but I think it's pretty much ready to paint. I think I need to do a little bit more, well, degreasing of this piece mostly. A little acetone takes care of that real fast. Brake cleaner would work for this, but I'm all out, so acetone it is. Probably not great for your fingers. But it takes all the junk right off, and the paint. But it's okay, because we're repainting it. So. So the problem is when you paint with a dark color underneath the color you're painting on top of, is it, unless you put a real thick coat, it tends to show through. So you can kind of see little bits of blue coming through in spots. Of course, I spent more time making the top side, which is what you'll be seeing more beautiful, but it'll be fine. And you can see the fiberglass is going to show through a little bit, but hey, it's a nice reminder of how we repaired this thing. And I think it looks pretty good. Alright, I got it all, it's dried out, and I got it flipped over and took the tape off of it, and I cleaned up the wheels and put them back on, and I think this thing's looking gorgeous. I mean, the true test is, does it match, which it doesn't, but I don't know, we'll see when I put it together. But I actually put the tires down a notch. I didn't even know, but there was another hole where they could go in, so now the whole thing's a little bit higher, and that means we won't scrape the bottom as much, which is good, because that's probably how it broke in the first place. And you can see that repair, the fiberglass, isn't even that visible. I mean, you can definitely tell, but it's not bad. It's really not bad. And, oh, it looks good. I mean, just look at that. Yeah, so I'm going to get this back together. You've seen me put it together a bunch of times, so we'll just do this. Whoa, it worked. That's cool, man. All right, well, it definitely kind of clashes. I mean, well, it doesn't clash, but you can tell it's a different shade. In fact, it looks worse in person than it does on camera. On camera, it actually looks pretty good. They look pretty close. But overall, I think it looks good. Definitely better than it was. I mean, this is a unit. The nice thing about this is it's truly cordless. You can literally go anywhere and this will run for hours, or as long as you need it to run and supply air. Wherever I need air, I can have it. After 6 months of working on this thing, it's finally done. I sure hope you enjoyed this video and also the series. If you've not seen the videos prior to this, I would encourage you to watch them. I will have a link to all of the videos in the description of this video. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time. You've seen me put it together a bunch of times, so we'll just do this. What? It didn't work! I'm going to include that in the black and white section. Me going, and then nothing happened. Oh, that would be so funny.